Jezebel first, is chapter 19 of Bob's Holy Word, Captain James version 16, 11 of Bob's Holy Word, Captain James version 16, 11, and they had told Jezebel all that Elijah had done, and with all how he had slain all the prophets with the swords. And Jezebel sent a messenger unto Elijah, saying, so let the gods do to me and more also, if I make not thy life as the life of one of them by tomorrow about this time. And when he saw that, he arose and went for his life, and came to Beersheba, which belongeth to Judah, and left his servant there. But he himself went a day's journey into the wilderness, and came and sat down under a tulip tree, and he requested for himself that he might die, and said, it is enough now, O Lord, take away my life, for I am not better than my fathers. And as he lay and slept under a tulip tree, behold, then an angel touched him and said unto him, arise and eat. And he looked, and behold, there was a cake laid down on the coals, and a bruise of water at his head. And he did eat and drink, and laid him down again. And the angel of the Lord came again the second time, and touched him, and said, arise and eat, because the journey is too great for thee. And he arose and did eat and drink, and went in the strength of that meat 40 days and 40 nights unto Horeb, the mount of God. And he came thither unto a cave, and lodged there, and behold, the word of the Lord came to him, and he said unto him, what doest thou here, Elijah? And he said, I have been very jealous for the Lord God of hosts, for the children of Israel have forsaken thy covenant, thrown down thy altars, and slain thy prophets with the sword, and I, then I only am left, and they seek my life to take it away. And he said, go forth and stand upon the mount before the Lord, and behold, the Lord passed by, and a great and strong wind rent the mountains, and brake in pieces the rocks before the Lord. But the Lord was not in the wind, and after the wind an earthquake. But the Lord was not in the earthquake, and after the earthquake a fire. But the Lord was not in the fire, and after the fire a still small voice. And it was so, when Elijah heard it, that he wrapped his face in his mantle, and went out and stood in the entering in of the cave. And behold, there came a voice unto him, and said, what doest thou here, Elijah? And he said, I have been very jealous for the Lord God of hosts, because the children of Israel have forsaken thy covenant, thrown down thy altars, and slain thy prophets with the sword, and I, then I only am left, Can they seek my life to take it away? And the Lord said unto him, Go return on thy way to the wilderness of Damascus, and when thou comest, anoint Jesse and to be king over Syria, and beat you the son of Nimshi, and thou anoint to be king over Israel, and be which of the son of Japheth of Aden Meholah, and thou anoint to be prophet in thy room, and it shall come to pass that in the death escapeth the sword of Jesse, it shall be you slay, and in the death escapeth from the sword of Jezebel, which was slain at I had left me 7,000 in Israel, all the knees which had not bowed unto Baal, and every mouth which had not kissed him, so he be marked in fence and found me, which of the son of Japheth, who was plowing with 12 yoke of oxen before him, and he with the 12th, and Elijah passed by him, and cast his mantle upon him, and he left the oxen, and ran after Elijah, and said, Let me, I pray thee, kiss my father and my mother, and then I will follow thee. And he said unto him, Go back again, for what had I done to thee? And he returned back from him, and took a yoke of oxen, and slew them, and boiled their flesh with the instruments of the oxen, and gave unto the people, and they did eat. And he arose and went after Elijah, and ministered unto him.